Malachi is the last prophets before John the Baptist. In between, there were 400 years. So God chose a prophet in such a way that his teaching will sustain for the coming 400 years. That's why the book of Malachi is very important. The very word Malachi means the messenger of Yahweh. He is the prophet. His co-companions, like the prophet Nehemiah, they are all getting old, and then God raises up this young man called Malachi. In his days, there were four disturbing things happened. Number one, the priests were corrupted. They were ready to bless people if they give money. They are ready to go to homes if they give good food, if they give something favors. We can check whether it is the same thing repeating. The first thing Malachi faced in his heart was a broken spirit. Lord, how much you loved us. And look at our priests, how they have become corrupted. And the second thing he saw was the wicked practices. Man can do as he thinks. He can come to the church, he can be holy. The moment he goes out, he practices his own filthy language, his own wrong relationship, wrong habits. He goes anywhere, nobody can question him. It affected him. How can people in the temple, one person outside, they are something completely different. Some even go to sorcery. He will be in the third chapter. Malachi will refer about that. About sorcery, about black magic, all kinds of things. The same children of God offering to all kinds of wrong gods, wrong type of living. They come to the temple to celebrate. Outside, they live in sinful life. Nothing affects them. In the heart, Malachi was crying, Lord, what's happening to your people? Who will save us, Lord? A man in the spirit, he feels that. First thing he saw was the corruption among the priests. The second thing he saw was a kind of wicked practice. Third thing he saw was compromising the leaders. The leaders who are supposed to lead the community, if they are their relatives, they give one kind of justice. If they find some are influential, they give a type of support. They close eyes to the poor, to those who are really suffering. And the fourth important thing he saw was a false kind of security. The same children of God who are supposed to find their security in the Lord. As we read in Proverbs 18:10, the name of the Lord is a great tower where people enter and they are safe. But now they have forgotten their God. They have false security in money, in the world, in the influence. And when we look back, the same thing continues even today into our lives. In that time when he cried, he saw the vision of two things were shown to him. The first thing he saw, the fire. And the another thing he saw, the soap. The fire burns away and the soap cleans away. So, the Lord says, my son, teach my people to burn away certain things, like thorny bushes, like thorny relationship, that which pricks them, which leads them to sin, to sinful habits. So they have to be burnt away. They need to check their lives. See, I do not know whether you have sugar cane in your field. If you go to Tamil Nadu, certain areas especially, in our areas, you will see sugar cane. What do they do to sugar cane? First, they burn up the previous sugar cane, that is the roots. They will cut from down and the root will remain there. And after some time, it will be dried up. In the heat of April, May, it will be terrible heat. It will be dried up. But it will not, you cannot pull it out. Even if you pull it, it will not come. Even if the roots are dried up. So what do? They put the fire. And the fire, it remains there. So the fire on the top, it goes deep into every root. And they leave it. And if it is needed, some places they will put even kerosene. Whereby it goes deep into the root and every root is being burnt away. That is the thing the Lord showed to Malachi. What is needed for my people is a fire to burn away. They have to cry, Lord, these are my roots. Though I want to come out, I am not able to. There are so many things that are pulling me down. What are the things that are pulling me down? Has to be burnt. If they are not burnt, they will be replaced again. So this is the vision God gave to Malachi. There is, you have cut them, but the next rain comes, they will once again come up. But they won't produce good crop like the earlier ones. So they have to be burnt away. So what are the things that pull my life? I need to check. And I have to allow His fire to burn me off. And the second thing, vision that God gave to Malachi was soap. So God comes as a refiner and as a purifier. These are the two terms given to Malachi. That's what we read in Malachi chapter. He will come soon. Who can endure the day of coming? Who can stand when He appears? For He is like a refiner's fire and a launderer's soap. He will sit as a refiner and as a purifier. So, the first time you refine means you burn away with the fire. And then, immediately what they do, they plow out. They use the plow and pull away all those roots which are upburned, which are still there. It is easier now. And they just pull it away. And then prepare the ground. So one side, certain things have to be pulled away from us. And second, we have to use plows to prepare ourselves. We have to use soap to clean up our bodies. Here we don't cut off our bodies, but we purify. And the fire, we burnt away certain things. And through the soap, we clean up certain things which are not pleasing. In put it in a New Testament language, Jesus says in John 15:2, I am the vine, you are the branches. If you have to bear fruit, I will cut off some of your branches and I will Some I will prune it. Pruning is not fully cutting up. Here and there they will cut. What is wild, completely cut it off. And where it is bearing fruit, certain branch, you may have seen roses, you prune it. And where you prune from the rose comes. The same way, if wherever the vine is pruned from there, the vine which allows itself to be pruned, from there the fruits come. Fruits doesn't come from the vine. It comes from the branches which have allowed itself to be pruned. So where you are cutting, where you don't want yourself to be, unwanted things, one side the wild things have been cut and thrown away, and the other side, unwanted elements, I have to prepare and cut it off that I may bear fruit. One side, my roots have to be burnt away, that which is not meant of God. On the other side, I have to prepare my heart to receive Him.